Good morning, everybody. We are Easy Fly, and our group members are Abhijat, Vishal, Parishkit, and Furma. The vision of the company is mainly to become leaders in the airlines with worldwide network coverage in the and diversified business. So we, in our strategic plan, from the beginning itself, we have been focusing on our, how to diversify our business. We'll be talking about diversification and other stuff. The responsibilities given are like finance manager and asset manager to Parishkit Khanal, marketing manager and PR manager. Responsibilities are handled by Purva Chiring Sherpa. Human resource manager and operations are handled by Vishal Sharma. And me will be leading as the president of the organization. The first we're going to talk about is the management process. What kind of management process we are applying in our organizations. We are applying bottom-up management process. This is basically encouraging and employing the lower level employees, different department managers to take decisions. So rather than just having a vote for going in a decision, we actually come up with discussions to come to a conclusion and take decisions accurately. And the main and important strategy for our airlines is that we have applied Blue Ocean strategy. We have focused on to tap the customers who are frequent travelers and low cost travelers. We instead of competing with other airlines, we have set a benchmark to keep us above the quality and reliability and offer the same services at a lower cost than other competitors. This combination created an offering that enabled customers to benefit from high traveling speed of airplanes and low price combined with flexibility. So our main focus is also even to target the customers, passengers who are traveling through trains and cars. We invested more in advertising, promotion, quality and training accordingly. Okay, this is the strategy canvas we used to differentiate our airlines. Basically, our airlines has a price which is like slightly above the discounted, but we give all the features of luxury and discounted accordingly. We have already given free food services above the line marketing. We are accessibly funding our marketing and promotion campaign. We have thoroughly invested on CSR. We have just employee turnover. Our reliability is extremely high, and we have implemented the best HR policy. And the main focus has been the hub and connect network, which means basically our routes are expanded into 10 routes, so which would help us to gain market. And on the training part, to improve on our quality, we have focused highly on training, and we delivered the highest quality with other airlines from our competition that have liked. This helps us create a Blue Ocean market for our airlines and separate us from the other competition. You can see the luxury airlines Falcon Air, which has been competing with us neck and neck, but they were actually not our competition. We were fighting our market in economic class. Through fighting and running our airlines with economic class, we took their market in most of the quarters, and almost in the last quarter we lost our same price. We'll be talking about in the coming slides.
So I'll take one from here. First is the analysis of industry. On this, we have used the Porter's Five Force model. Porter's Five Force model is a framework that analyzes the level of competition within the industry and helps for business development strategy. On this, first you can see the competitive rivalry. As in a normal segment, there are not much competition, but only three airlines which company operate in the normal segment. And secondly, at the threat of new entrants, since there are only 8 groups, there is no threat of new entrants in it. And third, there is the power of suppliers. As there is no control over the fuel price, the power of supply is kind of less, but in the employee turnover, it can affect the sales and quality. And third is the power of buyers. As all the airlines have similar prices, the buyers have kind of high power in this force model. And finally, threats of substitute. As the airlines are operating at a very economic rate, it's less than the average price of high-speed train and cars. That's why there is no substitute, in a way. Yeah. And balanced scorecard. Balanced scorecard is the strategic framework which takes into account of the non-customer, non-financial perspective, such as the customer perspective, financial customer perspective. On this, we have four aspects. First, there is customer perspective. The first customer perspective goal is to improve the quality and reliability. And on this, we have taken the measure, like we focus more on the quality and training. And secondly, we have focused on the maintenance level of the airlines. And secondly, we have the financial perspective. On this, our goal is to improve our debt and equity ratio. And secondly, we wanted to reduce the overdraft. So we have taken the measure to firstly issue share in first two quarter and have less shareholders. And thirdly, there is the training and development. On this, we have our goal was to motivate the staff and reduce staff turnover. So the measure we have taken is to give the 20% profit to the employees and also pay the market wage above it, above the normal market wage. Yeah. And then marketing and promotion. On marketing and promotion, we have focused mainly on advertising. Promotion has been done through advertising. And it's a advertising is a medium to which our customer can be attracted. So as you can see, we have focused our promotion in a way that we are above, we are the market leaders on spending of promotion. On the promotion, we have spent around 68,000, and even in advertising, 68,000 with 25,000 on the cargo budget. We have tried to maintain our airline fare around 38 cents. So we have also used some of the promotional fare in some quarters, like we have given some free food and drinks at some quarters, and even we have applied the two and three month fare sale. And then we have also invested some of our money at market research. $25,000 has been allocated to spend on the market research. And we had initially used one sales staff for the marketing purpose, but later on we hired another one through special incident. So my friend Vishal will continue from here.
Good morning, respected teachers. To make the second best company in the airline business, we focused on operating management, HRM and fleet decisions. In the operating management, route management was the key role in deciding the fate of our company. We decided short routes for small planes and larger planes for the longer routes. Altogether, we have 10 routes, as you can see here, with 27 flights per day. To boost up the sales, we ensured 2 to 3 months sales, in which we had 5 to 15% discounts for the customers, and less seats and shorter routes, we included regular fares. Maintenance and fleet decision. Maintenance, we ensured level 3 maintenance because maintenance impact was high, gave us higher reliability. All the fuel was purchased on the spot market because it was purchased instead. Though the fuel contract, by contracting, we could purchase it in a cheaper price, but we purchased it through fuels spot. We have total of 6 aircraft, out of which we have leased 2. And in the first quarter, we had 3 fleets. In the second, we added 2, and in the third quarter, we added 1. So we had a total of 6 fleets, in which the 2 were leased. Least because we had our cash involved in the promotional activities and expenses. We ensured level 3 maintenance, which costs up to $3,500 per aircraft per quarter, which amounted to $21,000 per quarter for all 6 aircraft. This ensured us higher reliability inside the market. Talking about employees, we have total of 164 employees and 2 salesperson at the end of the quarter 9, which showed us that we had 0% of turnover. In the first quarter, we 6 of our staff resigned from the company, but after that, when we started promotional activities, we gave 20% profit to all of our employees. No staff left our company, which gave us 0% turnover of the company. we had the highest quality and training budget with highest highest industry budget in the market. This we did this because we thought of blue ocean strategy. We thought that we could ensure this by ensure blue ocean strategy by creating 25% of profits to all employees and $80,000 on quality and training budget.
Financing weakness in our financial decision was that we leased two aircraft. We leased two aircraft, Canadian Air CRJ-100 and Aerospatial ETR-42, which by leasing these two aircraft, our operating expenses rise more. Our operating expenses increases, so that the profit, which our stock price has been decreased. Highest dividend paid in each quarter is from quarter 2 20,003, 40,480. From 5 on from quarter 5 it's $50,000, and the total from 5, 6, 7, 8 is the same, and the total is 90,000, and this is the maximum dividend we gave, but due to our mismanagement we took an overdraft. And cash management, in every quarter we paid dividend to our each shareholder. We paid dividend, and our basic objective was to clear the loan which have we have taken to buy the aircraft and improve our debt. The stock price we are in for easy flight. The stock price is continuously increased, and our highest stock price performance is in quarter 6, which is 51.21. And reason for drop in the stock price in selected quarters are in quarter 4, like we diversify our company by investing around 2 lakh in our regional sector, and in quarter 7 our we have to pay. We paid a dividend to our respective shareholders, in which our overdraft loan has been increased. And incident we took that our we hired two company employee. We hire two employee competitors, and one of our competitors have hired our chief pilot. In which our due to which our sales decreases, so stock price also decreased by that reason. And in quarter similarly in quarter 8 due to the seasonal weather, due to the winter season it was accorded, so the flight were not consistently done, so the stock price was also dropped due to less sales. And net income is profit, it's in positive in all figure, and we haven't faced loss in any quarter.
Okay, now I'm going to talk about return on equity. Like the industry average, like from the first quarter itself, has been in minus, and we were always on the positive side of the positive side on the return on equity. It vastly helped our investors to understand what our company was going through, because this is calculated upon by net profit upon by total equity of the company. And return on sales, like also like we have like mainly focused focus on operational effectiveness, which means like although our passenger load factor has been on the higher side, almost on the average of 72-75% from quarter 3 to quarter 9, it also shows reflects in our return on sales. From quarter 5 you can see the major improvement. On 6 there is a highest of 0.072, which was because of our maximum earning, maximum net profit earning on that quarter. We also managed to gain the highest sale price on quarter 6 with $51.74 per share in that quarter. And moving on to rest of the quarters, we did fairly positive in the as on the till 9, but on the 7 and 8 we are like losing our market to other competitors, and which is reflecting on our return on sales. And on the part of return on assets, again it's on the better side than the industry average. On the we are on the positive side from 0.013 to 0.058 on the better side of our company.
So I'll talk about from the two points of view, from the investor point of view and from the customer point of view. Firstly, from the investor point of view, we had the highest stock price till quarter eight, and secondly, we have the highest cumulative income from the whole airline industry. Thirdly, we have the highest net income, and even our performance ratios such as the return on equity, return on sales and return on assets were the one of the best in the industry. We never faced a We never faced a loss in any quarters, and among the dividend paid, we were one of the highest to pay around 1,50,000 or 1% per share. Then from the customer point of view, we were the highest in the quality rating and in the reliability rating. Our markets were mostly covered in route R and route F. We had 6 aircrafts on which 4 were owned and 2 were leased. And we have also diversified our business with the auto rental. And finally, we have the most highly motivated employee with the zero turnover rate. And we have achieved the best regional airlines.
Okay, I'm going to talk about the important critical incident. On the critical incident, on the quarter 7, high competitors employee, it was like both positive and negative side. Like, we hired the new sales managers and some results were positive, but also we lost the chief maintenance officer, and that resulted in late in few flights and drop in our quality, which reflected on our share prices. And some of the next decisions of hiring decision on quarter 8 was like, from quarter 7 we learned that we should be more ethical towards hiring, and the group suggested that we hire internally, and which gave a positive message to our company. In the special decision of quarter 9, deciding on the incident of purchasing policy, we decided to choose on the lower bidder because like they gave us a 30 days late pay cancellation option, and the main important from the message we got was like they implemented technology. So we are focusing our company to be more focused on technology perspective. Okay, I'm quickly going to talk about the SWOT analysis. The strength has been the high passenger load, high routes, high stock price, safety and reliability, which has been on the highest side. Total of 6 aircraft. Opportunities has been expanding further into F&R route, operating normal fare in the luxury class routes, and we are giving a top competition to Falcon Airways. And diversification also helped us to gain other incomes. Weaknesses has been the higher operating cost due to leasing. We focus on normal fare, not into luxury services. And threats has been rising competition and rising operating costs. Okay, the strategy has been from this the delivery strategy. Like initially we had planned to give 150,000 share every quarter from quarter 5, but we realized that we were going below the overdraft, and that this resulted us to go minus in most of the quarter. Okay, the future plans, we plan to shift to luxury class if we continue our goal, and we will beat the other competitors. We'll try to reduce our operating expenses, means we'll focus on buying and purchasing new aircraft. Purchase a new aircraft rather than lease. To reduce debt to equity ratio, we'll focus on that and reduce dividend. The conclusion of the simulation game has been like, although our company is the second position, we managed to learn about asset management, learn the importance of marketing and promotion, impact on sales. Proper IHRM plays a beautiful ethical role in motivating the employees. The critical incidents were vitally important for us to understand the real-time problems which we will face in the real business world. Thank you.